Hello Cloud Gurus and welcome back to another AWS This Week, where we find out what AWS have been up to in the past 7 days. This week, AWS have released the Elemental Link UHD, AWS Backup now supports crash-consistent backups of EBS volumes. Closely related to that, Amazon EC2 now allows you to create crash-consistent AMIs. And Windows Server and SQL Server EC2 instances get per second billing. It's AWS This Week with me, Nick Triantafillou. Before we begin, just a quick note to all our YouTube watchers, we have a YouTube experience survey we'd love you to fill out to give us some feedback on what you want to see and what you don't want to see on our YouTube channel. The link is in the description if you could kindly check that out. Okay, on to our headlines. All right, the big announcement this week is that AWS have just released the Elemental Link UHD. This is an Ultra HD version of their high-efficiency video coding encoding device that can connect an ultra-high-definition video source, like a camera, to AWS Elemental Media Live for processing video in the AWS cloud. The older version, the Elemental Link, announced in 2020, could handle 1080p at 60 frames per second with an 8-bit color depth. The new Ultra HD can handle 4K at 60 frames per second with a 10-bit color depth. The devices are fast and easy to set up and ship fully configured to your AWS account. Many companies are already using these devices for a wide variety of streaming applications, from enterprise events, live sports, music, fitness classes, and even live surgery to train medical professionals. A very cool device and service, be sure to check them out. Next up, by default, AWS Backup now supports crash-consistent backups of EBS volumes which are attached to EC2 instances. This means that AWS Backup users no longer have to stop their instances or coordinate between multiple EBS volumes attached to the same EC2 instances to get a crash-consistent backup. In a very similar vein, and I'm assuming using the same underlying technology, Amazon EC2 now allows you to create crash-consistent AMIs from instances with multiple EBS volumes without having to reboot the instance. The AMI created will retain data from all completed I/O operations from each volume attached to the instance. This means you can launch an instance from the AMI and return to the exact state prior to the creation of the image. Previously, to do any of this, you had to manually pause any I/O operations before creating an AMI. Or you had to shut down the machine or reboot it during AMI creation. AWS have now made this process significantly easier. Finally this week, Amazon EC2 Windows Server and SQL Server instances are now billed per second instead of per hour. This applies to all on-demand, reserved, and spot instances running on EC2. They're now all billed in 1 second increments with a minimum of 60 seconds. Anyone using a large amount of instances running for strange lengths of time, such as for development or testing, will benefit significantly from this, as you will no longer have to worry about maximizing your usage to 1 hour blocks. You can simply use the instances as required and you will be billed for that usage and that usage only. Now, just a reminder that the A-Cloud Guru Community Summit is coming up on June 28th to 30th. It will be 3 days with 6 cloud learning tracks covering AWS, GCP, Azure, AI, machine learning, data, DevOps, Linux, and much, much more. Check out the link below to register for free. All right, that's all for me this week. Keeping awesome, Cloud Gurus, and we'll see you next time.